Okay, well, I have a little advice for Best Buy. When you're closing 2,500 fucking stores over the last few years, I suggest you be a little more functional with your web page. Because from what I can see here, nothing fucking works at all. Best Buy. You can click on the menu, you can type in Marantz. What you get is, well, we have 62 items. They show you three, absolutely the most expensive units. And then they got pictures on the left-hand side. None of them function. Contacting them doesn't function. Contacting support doesn't function. Basically, nothing on the web page works. And if I was Best Buy and I wanted to go out of business, the first thing I would do is fuck my web page up. So that people couldn't go and look at items they might consider purchasing from Best Buy. Instead, you're going to make it as hard as possible. Oh, we have to turn off your cookies. You see, unless you turn off your cookies, we can't let you use our web page. Yeah, you see, these are the kind of corporate decisions that sink companies. Does anyone remember Circuit City? Well, I can remember exactly what killed that company, and it was customer service. Destroyed that company. Luckily, I knew Mike Martin. He was the last senior manager at the Circuit City here before they closed in Reading. And now we're only left with Best Buy, and their website is garbage. Garbage. It does nothing. Oh, well, store locator, tell us where you live. Give us all this information, and then the website is completely non-functioning. And so, if you want to know why Best Buy is going out of business and closing all of these stores, this is why. Number two, we used to joke when we went up there. All we want is an HDMI cable, a 6-foot HDMI cable. Okay? Pretty simple, item. You can get one for $6 at Amazon. We go up to Best Buy, and here's an entire aisle of HDMI cables, and they're all from one seller. That's it. One seller. You got one choice to buy from this group, and the same cable that was $6 at Amazon that would take 2 days to get here was $35. $35. At Best Buy. Then their geek squad. I call them the theft squad. I often do the video where I talked about there was an elderly couple. I say elderly couple. They were older than me, but this was, God, this was because I quit going up there, fuck, 10 years ago. Okay. So I was younger. And this, it was grandma and grandpa, and they were buying it for their grandson. And it was a PlayStation 3 Slam or something. Anyway, the Geek Squad guy behind the counter tried to convince this elderly couple that they needed to pay $300 to update the PlayStation. I looked at him and when it came out of his mouth. He was kind of looking at me, giving me the little side eye like this, because he could tell I'm looking at him like, what the fuck? I looked at those people and I said, ma'am, listen, I don't know why this guy's telling you this, but if you take that home and plug it in, it's going to update all on its own. It's going to be free. I have no idea why this guy's telling you that. How old's your grandson? They said he's 10 years old. I said, he's going to know how to do it. $300 to update the PlayStation. Can you believe that? That's criminal. That's fraud. It's fraudulent action. This is why Best Buy is going out of business. So I go up there for a DVD. That's where I got all my DVDs. I go up there for to get DVDs. Well, we don't have a 3D section anymore because it's not popular enough. I'm like, how fucking much does it cost you to have a couple of copies of that 3D movie there? What does it cost you to have a couple of copies sitting there on the shelf? Oh, well, we have not enough demand. And okay, well, guess what? I haven't been up there in 10 fucking years. Do you get the point? Do you understand why you're closing so many stores? every time I turned around up there, my little Logitech computer system, audio system, went, the one that they had two boxes that were open in their little computer area, two boxes, okay, both opened. And I asked the guy, I said, why is the box cut open? He goes, oh, we inspect, and he gave me this long fucking story. I bring it home, I plug it in, that's all that would come out of it. I take it back up there, and the next fucking day, it's back on the shelf. I told the manager about it, okay, and the next day it was on the shelf. So as I'm leaving, I go to the west wall, and I head down. I head north to their appliances section, and here's 10 brand new unopened boxes of the same audio system stacked up, 10 of them. But what did they offer their customers? Two fucking broken ones. Now, this is why Best Buy is going out of business. It's not that hard to figure out, people. If you're going to fuck your customers over at every opportunity and take advantage of them in every single way you can, sooner or later, they're going to go to Amazon and they're going to pay $6 instead of $35, okay? And when you have your geek squad trying to milk $300 out of an elderly couple to update a PlayStation that's going to update itself when you plug it in, that's fucking criminal action, okay? This is why Best Buy is failing.